Our weekly update with the head coach of the Jackrabbit softball program, Kristina McSweeney. And let's go back to last Wednesday and start with the win at Minnesota. It's one thing to go on the road, beat a Big Ten team, but to play as well in all facets as you did, that was a very impressive performance in the Twin Cities.
Yes, impressive is an understatement. I was just pleased with how poised we were. Shin and Lacey was incredible on the mound to start the game with a walk and then be able to just power through a very tight strike zone, if I will say. But just she was able to keep them off balance, was able to keep them, you know, just chasing balls down. She threw incredible. And then we had clutch performances when we needed the most. You know, we talk about teams that are successful are the teams that are able to hit in situational moments the best. So, you know, Emma Osmondson stepped up and cleared a bases with an incredible hit when we needed it. And it was right after that hit that you can just tell Minnesota knew, oh gosh, they are good. You know, so there was a moment of that there that you can see, and they just powered through. I mean, they were just really, really good when we needed them to be.
You highlighted the two individuals who were honored by the Summit League this week for performances, and I want to bring them up as we'll talk about the wins over St. Thomas as well. But we begin with Emma Osmondson, 5 for 9 in the three games, drove in 9. She hit for the cycle combined throughout the three games. She seems like a young lady who is trying to make sure her career lasts as long as possible as she comes down this stretch run.
Yes. You know, her confidence to me exudes greatness. You know, she gets in the box and you can just tell right away you don't want to miss, you know, especially with her. She has turned it on here at the end and has really looked at her swing and tried to perfect it. And that's what makes her who she is. She just tries to be better every single time she gets on the field. She's been a force to be reckoned with, and she'll finish strong for sure.
Shannon Lacey is oftentimes lurking in the shadows because of Tori Kanishi and the job that TK has done. We talked about Lacey's performance against Minnesota. You factor in what she did against St. Thomas. 2 starts, 2 complete games, 2 shutouts. That's nothing to sneeze at.
Absolutely not. You know, and she continues to get on the mound and fights her way through these games. And, you know, last year it was getting used to the Division I atmosphere and getting used to the Division I enemy. And now she has learned how to conquer that enemy. Just crisper, tighter. She's able to control hitters more. She knows what she wants the ball to do. And you're absolutely right. She's a kid that kind of is in the shadow, but she's trying to make a name for herself and trying to finish as strong as she can as well.
You only get 2 games in against St. Thomas. You sweep that doubleheader on Saturday, and there were a lot of logistical issues to figure out. You end up getting to play them at home, and the biggest part of that is this senior class, the most loaded, the most appreciated in the history of Jackrabbit softball, and rightfully so, to be able to have a moment for them on their field. Emotionally, what was that like?
Oh, I was a wreck the whole week, and I will continue to be a wreck. But, you know, woke up that morning, it was 7:30. Our facilities director, Christy, and Josh looked at me and they said, how bad do you want to play here? And I was like, I'm willing to work for the next 7 hours to get this if this is what they want. So, yes, it was a lot of back and forth, a lot of emotional turmoil. You know, I did not want to celebrate our seniors at another location, so I was willing to do just about anything to get it done. Very emotional to think about what these girls have done here at South Dakota State for the last 4 and some 5 years and some 2 years is incredible. They will leave a lasting legacy. They have changed the face of this program, and the challenge that they have left for us and for the remaining Jackrabbits that we will have, the baby rabbits, is to continue their legacy and to continue doing the great things that they have done, which is amazing.
Well, you know you'll be a top 2 seed in the Summit League tournament. You know you will host it here in just a little more than a week. But will you be the 1 seed? Will you be a regular season league champ and host it next year? That'll be decided this week. What a matchup it'll be. South Dakota State, Omaha, top 2 teams in the league. Kanishi, Meyer, all the headlines for the pitchers. This is why you do this, right? To be able to play the 2 best teams playing for it all in the last week of the regular season.
You're exactly right. And when I looked at the schedule, you know, almost 9 or 10 months ago, I said the conference will be decided this weekend. I knew it. I knew going into this season that we were going to be right where we are right now. I am hoping that the preparation that we've put in the preseason and being able to see the top tier pitching will prepare us for what we will see this weekend. The will of our team and what we have built this season will show our best softball, and just playing with a little bit of revenge and getting that moment to square it right is what we are going to be playing for this weekend for sure.
Last question for you. When it comes to Omaha, people immediately go to Cameron Meyer, and rightfully so. Her numbers are staggering. But to suggest they're a one-woman show is a falsity. What else impresses you besides Cameron Meyer about the Mavericks?
Their offense. Their offense is stellar. I mean, they are similar to us, similar to offensive numbers. They have, I believe it's 6 hitters hitting above 300, several in the top categories within the Summit League. Their offense will be a challenge for us, and we're going to have to be our best on the mound to beat them one game, if not two or three. So it's going to be us performing in all facets that's going to help control their offense. And, you know, they're going to be low scoring, great games. I'm excited about it. This is why we do what we do. But going out there and getting the chance to compete against them is what we're waiting on. So I'm excited to see what the Jackrabbits do.